College football Saturdays on Fox Sports Net. It's game time, baby. You ready? Let's go. You know when the action's on. Choose what side you're on. Speed and power, build a squad. Let's go, let's go. 1 yard can change the odds. Fans and cheerleaders are getting it on. Just yards to the zone. The game is on. 60 minutes on the clock. Players looking in. You steal the rock. Let the defense line them up. QB trying to pass them up. Come on. The fans and mascots are on deck. College football Saturday is on next. Huh.
In the great state of Oklahoma, it is known as the Bedlam Series, and do they know how to have a good time. Brilliant weather for the matchup between the Cowboys and the Sooners, and a very determined look on the face of Quentin Griffin, especially after what happened last year. College Football Saturday, presented by Kia Zara, welcomes you to Stillwater. As the number three team in the nation, the Oklahoma Sooners, the winners of the Big 12 South, take on the Oklahoma State Cowboys. And revenge on the mind of the Sooners after what happened here, or at least in Norman last year. Josh Fields, 94 seconds left of the game. Rashaun Woods, the game winner. A stunned group of Oklahoma Sooners. And in the first season for Les Miles, an orange bat. Hi, everybody. I'm Joel Myers alongside Dave Lapman. Welcome to Stillwater. Well, Dave, in each of the last two seasons, the Sooners have been as good as any team in college football. This year, they feel like they're even better because of the balance they have now with a better ground game.
And they run that football. Griffin is the key to it. This kid's unbelievable. 5'7", 190 pounds. He can make you miss, deceptively strong, tremendous balance, can balance himself with either hand or either foot. He's very, very tough to knock off his feet. Defensively, they have a Butkus Award finalist for the best linebacker in college football in Teddy Lehman. This guy was a high school sprinter on his track and field team. I'll tell you, he makes big play after big play. 6'3", 235, runs 4'4". He's a size-speed ratio nightmare.
Well, the Cowboys of Oklahoma State have a good thing going, and it's only going to get better in the passing game with Josh Fields, a sophomore, and his favorite target, a junior, Rashaun Woods.
And Rashaun Woods, I think, is one of the best receivers in college football. He does everything well. Great, precise route runner. Gets in and out of his cut so very, very well. And then when the ball is in the air, he makes the contested catch. He gets himself in position because he times his jump so well, and he's got such tremendous body control. And then finally, the catch. He's got oversized hands for his body type, and he's very, very soft-handed. So he catches everything in his catching radius. He's the real deal.
The Sooners still have national championship aspirations. Yeah, joining now the third member of our team, let's head downstairs with Eric Clements. Eric.
Joel, thank you very much. You know, in the continuation of this Bedlam series, throw all national rankings and statistics right out the window. The last two games have been decided by a total of 8 points. In last year's Oklahoma State 16-13 upset at Norman, they held the Oklahoma running game to 0 net yards. And if they're to shut down the run again this afternoon, big 6'5", 290-pound defensive tackle Kevin Williams will play a huge role. Coaches on both sides of the football say nobody in the nation has played the position any better than number 58 this year. He leads all Oklahoma State interior linemen with tackles for loss with 10, also has 4 sacks. Oklahoma's going to have to keep a body on number 58 if they're to run the ball successfully today.
In only his 4th year as the head coach of the Oklahoma Sooners, Bob Stoops with a phenomenal winning percentage. Great road record. Now, what a job they have done when it comes to just simply stopping the opposition. They excel defensively. It sets up their offense in great field position. And ever since he arrived, it has turned things around in Norman. Now, the Cowboys are hoping for the same thing from their head coach in only his 2nd season. But already his 2nd season, they are bowl eligible. And Les Miles pulled it off last year. A dramatic 16-13 win on the road in Norman. So two of the guys that we really like to work with and talk with in the Big 12. Now we're lucky because we come in early and we get to spend time with people like Les Miles and Bob Stoops. And we thank them for all their help all year long. And that's Gary Barnett. We can go down the list of the people that we've worked with, like Mike Leach at Texas Tech, Quentin Griffin. You think he wants it a little bit because of Quentin Griffin this year? Oklahoma already has 680 more yards on the ground in 11 games than they had in 12 games all last season, Dave.
Well, Quentin Griffin's got 1,450 yards, and he's been so efficient in getting those, averaging 6.8 yards per rush, third best in the NCAA. Very, very productive running back.
Still a shot at the national championship game for the Oklahoma Sooners. They'll need a win today and then need help. Somebody beating Miami, either Syracuse today or Virginia Tech next week, Dave.
Right, Ohio State's in. Miami's got Cuse up in the dome today, but they seem to be handling things pretty well early on, and then they play Virginia Tech in Miami, a home game. Tough task for the Hokies, who've lost three in a row.
Back deep, as Cole Farden will kick it away. Antoine Savage over to the far side. Antonio Perkins to the near side, and we are ready for game number 97 of the Bedlam Series. Good to have you with us on Fox Sports Net. Classic football weather. It's Stillwater, Oklahoma, and here we go. Good kick. It'll be Perkins from the three. And a lane up the middle. He's belted at the 22. Otherwise, he's gone. He is straight up the hash. But Vernon Grant, the defensive back, puts him down. Offensively, for the Sooners, Nate Hybl, the senior from Hazelhurst, Georgia, transferred from the Bulldogs program. And what a young group. Out of their first 10 on the offensive line, 7 of the 10 freshmen or sophomores. Griffin, exceptional running back. Savage faking the wide receivers along with Will Peoples. Trent Smith, an award-winning tight end, the senior from Clinton, Oklahoma. So Hybl will start it off in the shotgun. He's hit 56% of his passes this year. 17 scores. Smith's his target, and he loses yardage. Loses about 3 on first down. Albert Craig, the safety, all over him, and Darren Williams, the first one in. So the sophomore from Fort Worth, Texas, the first one on the stop.
Darren Williams made a great reaction to the play. They tried the little tight end screen, although the tight end lined up in the slot.
Kiesera starting 11 defensively, and it is a 4-2-5, Dave, which should play well against a team like the Sooners that likes to put it up on a regular basis. Call it a loss of 2. It'll be 2nd and 12. Griffin, get him as many touches as possible. And good yardage across the 25. Little swing pass out to the 29-yard line for a gain of 9. Tripped up by the redshirt freshman, outside linebacker Paul Duren.
That's saying something to knock Griffin off his feet. Tremendous balance.
Not a lot to get a hold of, is there, Dave?
He doesn't have a whole lot of hitting surface at 5'7", 190 pounds. Deceptively strong. A lot of his strength in his lower body. His legs are put together. Squat 635 pounds.
So the first third down of the day, it belongs to the Sooners. Kewan Jones, a redshirt freshman from Jenks, Oklahoma, takes over in the backfield. And Hybl is going to throw for it. Popping it over to Smith. He's hit, and he's dropped again for a loss. Again, Darren Williams on the coverage. Kirk Milligan in on the hit. And in fact, goes Donnelly, 86, not Smith, 88.
They tried to break a little bit of a deal where they run the ball every time you bring in the tight end to run that power eye formation. Lance Donnelly, they threw it to him. But the thing that Oklahoma State did so well in that series was tackle as soon as the catch was made. No yards after catch.
Gabe Lindsay waiting for the punt from Blake Ferguson, who comes in with a 39-yard average. He's working downwind, and it's a low wobbler. And did it clip Lindsay on the way by? No. Awkwardly, he went by the football and got a break. So the Cowboys have great field position for their first possession of the contest, led by a sophomore quarterback from right here at Stillwater High School, Josh Fields.
That's
he
incredible.
Beat him last year.
That's incredible. 25 touchdowns, 9 interceptions.
Big guys on the corners. The tackles, Russell and Eaton. Tatum Bell, what a force he has been in the backfield behind Mike Denard. Lewis Woods, the award and record-setting wide receiver. And Billy Badgema, also only a sophomore from Oklahoma City, a tight end. They spread the defense. 5 wide receivers, empty backfield, 1 of the middle screen. Fields recognized they were going to take it away and throws it away. Now, that's something he wouldn't have done earlier in the year. So they took away the middle screen effectively.
They're flagged, Joel.
Defensively for the 9th best defensive unit in the nation, Wilkerson, Harris, Klein, and Jackson. Tommy Harris, he's a candidate for a number of trophies at the end of the year. Jackson, Mitchell, and Lehman, who's an award winner and a Butkus Award finalist. Wolfolk can straight on the corners, and Bassie and Everidge are the safeties.
Early edge goes to the defense because the adrenaline is flowing so freely. A little bit nervous offensively and big plays defensively.
Tighter formation in front of Tatum Bell. adjusting, but doesn't get much. Cracks it across the 28 to the 29. Wrapped up by Lance Mitchell, the middle linebacker.
Playing at a very high level is Lance Mitchell, as is Tatum Bell. Almost 6 yards per carry himself, and he's gained 12 pounds since last year. He's breaking more tackles as a result of it, and his endurance is a lot better. When they get into the fourth quarter of games, he's playing through being tired a lot more efficiently than he had in the past.
Over 1,600 yards in the last two seasons. And now second and 16 after the gain of four. Fields, after the play fake, wide open. Has his man near the 45. Nice break by Rashaun Woods. Who else? The junior from Oklahoma City in front of Andre Wolford and close to a first down.
That's the matchup that Oklahoma State wants to get, is Woods on Wolfolk and not on straight. Let's take a look at Teddy Lehman dropping back into his lane, trying to read the receivers coming on the potential crossing pattern. Ball goes out down the football field to the outer quadrant where Woods has run one of his precise routes as he normally does and gets separation out of the break on Wolfolk and made a great catch.
It looks like they're doubling up on the outside. Quick toss. Tatum Bell to the boundary. First down, Oklahoma State. Nifty move. Good call. Gets about 6 or 7. Brandon Everidge forced him out. So the wide side of the field, Tatum Bell, little guy, shows his quickness.
Well, when you're a great wide receiver like Rashaun Woods is, watch him work down the football field and block for his running back, Tatum Bell. That's a pretty nice job right there, securing a little bit of an edge for Tatum Bell to take advantage of. Teddy Lehman with the great speed, the inside-out pursuit from the safety, Everidge is phenomenal, but Woods did a nice job of stealing the cornerback.
Great field position on the first possession. Bell weaving his way for three. Pastor Johnson, the strong side linebacker, the junior from Hayward, California, got to him. But it's going to bring up second and short, second and a couple.
Les Miles decides on a first and five to put two tight ends in the football game and run right at Oklahoma. Thing with Oklahoma, they're so fast defensively, running east and west is a problem. They run you down. Get after them. Go north and south. Run right at them. Try to anchor them and stabilize them.
Oklahoma giving up only 287 yards a game, Dave. That is ninth best in the nation in total defense. Now on second and a couple. Nice moves. Patience. Bell waited for it. He gets it. He's got a first down to the Sooners 38. Waited for the kick out and got it.
Yeah, he was very patient. And what this does, Oklahoma State wants to get that running game established. Last year, they could not run the football at all. This year, they're running it much more effectively. Last year, for only the second time since 1940, they averaged less than 100 yards on the ground. They averaged 94 yards a game. This year, they're up over 140, much improved because of Tatum Bell's contributions.
He's the single with two to each side. No tight end in the formation. Quick one. Woods gets the block to the 35. And a nice block by another wide receiver downfield for him. John Lewis applied that little chip on the outside.
You know, whenever you have a play go to the perimeter, you have to have good blocking. Watch Lewis right here, just as you described, gets out by outside position on Wolfolk. It sustains contact, getting the edge established. When you pick up 5, 6, 7, 8 yards on first down, becomes a much easier game to call. Second and medium, second and short, everything's available to you game plan wise.
Multiple shifts now as they were strong to the short side. Works the other way. After the shift, Seymour Shaw in the backfield. And counterplay for Shaw. Bolting into the secondary to the 20. Will he go? Down to the 1 yard line.
Dropped the ball.
And he fumbled it into the end zone. Touchdown, Oklahoma State. John Lewis covers it after the Shaw fumble.
Take a look at what goes on here. Look at Oklahoma with the shifting. Look at Oklahoma's defense. How do I adjust? How do I adjust? They get the strength of the formation the other way. Now they run the counter back. These guys throw the great blocks. They pull the backside. Kick out, seal block, missed tackle by Brandon Everidge into the end zone for a touchdown after the fumble.
Luke Phillips, the junior from Tulsa, for the point after. And a perfect beginning for Oklahoma State.
And look, as the play concludes, that's Johnny on the spot right there. I mean, being in the right place at the right time is John Lewis as the ball is stripped. And Lewis finishes for six.
So a 64-yard drive for Oklahoma State, and they're leading the number three team of the nation early. The ultimate, if you're an Oklahoma State Cowboy fan, they've got a 7-0 lead after beating the Sooners last year. Now, don't forget the Sooners weren't a dominating team on the road this year like they have been at home. They won last week 60-15 against Tech, but they've had some close one days. We did that game at Mizzou when they barely beat the Tigers 31-24.
And you saw how strong this wind is here today, Joel. It blew the football right off the tee. Gusting up to 25 miles an hour at stages today. The wind's a huge factor. It's in Oklahoma State's back right now.
Varden kicks it away, a very high one. It's going to be Perkins from the five. Sets it up right, slowed down, and buried. Shy the 15, only to the 14. Are the Cowboys a little juiced up in their orange? Jones in the backfield. Well, we saw a good play by Lewis earlier on the block outside for Rashaun Woods. Spattling his way. Jones, the redshirt freshman from Jenks. Good yardage across the 15 out to the 18.
You know, this Oklahoma State football team beat Oklahoma in Norman last year. And they really, what they wanted to take out of that football game was remember how they took the field and played, the necessary intensity to compete in a game like that. That's what Les Miles wanted his team to learn. And it carried over. This year they had big wins against Texas A&M and Nebraska, and now they're competing well again today. They learned something from that contest last year in Norman.
Griffin and Works flanking Hybl in the backfield. The quick one. Nothing wrong. Mark Clayton, the target. Darren Williams, his counter, also wearing number 9. Taking care of it right away. No gain, basically, a yard at the most.
That's been the most significant thing in my eye early in this football game. Oklahoma, yards after catch, nothing. Oklahoma State, it seems like they're in the huddle. The route recognition is phenomenal. There's a defender there immediately after every catch of the football, and the journey ends right then.
So now, momentum-wise, early in the game, a big one, especially as far as field position is concerned, a 3rd and 5. Quentin Griffin, the only one in the backfield, with Nate Hybl. Blitz coming from the outside, and it'll be short of the first down, going to the tight end, Trent Smith. And Lance Donnelly instead.
And Donnelly slipped. Donnelly went to the turf after the catch. His feet went right out from under him. And a little bit of a bunch formation. And Donnelly and Smith both in the football game. And Donnelly, as he comes back to catch the football, his feet go out from under him. He goes right down at the 21-yard line.
Gabe Lindsey waiting for the punt from Blake Ferguson. And Ferguson hitting it into the wind. Hangs up a good one. No fair catch called for, and Lindsey dropped right at the 40-yard line. Good play downfield on the coverage for the Sooners. It was Will Peoples along with Antonio Perkins. But great field position again, second consecutive time. Cowboys by 7, will have it in their own 40. The Cowboys are doing a number on the Sooners early. Interested party down to the sideline right now with Eric Clemens. Eric.
All right, Joel, thank you. I've got Barry Switzer. He's won his share of Bedlam games. He's won a national championship or two and a Super Bowl as well. Talk about it early. Oklahoma, two possessions and has done really nothing offensively. What's the deal here?
Well, they got to have some success throwing down the field. They've thrown a lot of flare routes. That doesn't mean anything yet. If Oklahoma State can run the football, they got a chance to win the football game like any team does.
Now, talk about a heated rivalry like this, coach, as we watch the first down play of State. The heated rivalry like this where emotions run real high, and it looks like these teams have the same record coming in here, but Oklahoma's a big favorite.
Well, Oklahoma has a better record coming in here, but Oklahoma is the favorite. But Oklahoma, this is the emotional edge goes to Oklahoma State. There's no question about it. This is a big game playing here. They're ready to play. They want to prove something. This is another game for Oklahoma, and they can win it on form, but they got to be able to execute and throw the ball down the field.
All right, coach, enjoy it. Bring them some luck, maybe.
Thank you.
Coach Barry Switzer, of course, he's won his share of these Bedlam matchups. And guys, let's send it back up to you for what continues to be a very interesting first quarter.
And Dave, the Sooners don't usually beat themselves in the 4 years under Bob Stoops, but there is a big mental mistake early.
Yeah, frustration penalty right there. 15-yard penalty, personal foul, unsportsmanlike conduct on Oklahoma. And I think they feel that, you know, Oklahoma State's got control of this football game early, trying to do anything they can to recapture control, but you have to do it within the framework of the rules.
So Josh Fields with Bell split in the backfield along with Denard. Beautiful play fake. Buying time, going for the bundle. Woods is there. Touchdown, Oklahoma State.
Oklahoma State got the matchup they wanted once again. Woods on Andre Wilfolk. Little play action pass. Once you're able to establish a running game, that play fake, the fake of the run, freezes those linebackers and members of the secondary, and over the top went Rashaun Woods with a big play.
Luke Phillips happy to be out there again that quickly for a point after. Hard to believe. What a play fake though by Josh Fields. He froze the secondary. It was that good deception-wise.
Yeah, he did a nice job of hiding the football, and he couldn't believe it. He could have gone to either Woods, or he could have gone to John Lewis. Both his wideouts were open down the football field. The play-action fake was that good.
Ball is blown off the tee for Cole Farden, and no, it's not Bill Murray, and it's not Groundhog Day. We're not looking for Puxatony Phil, but Farden's kicking away again to Antoine Savage and Antonio Perkins and Les Miles. Is he a little relaxed on the sideline, feeling pretty good about his chances already?
I'll tell you what, Les Miles and Mike Gundy, the offensive coordinator for Oklahoma State, are doing so well, is mixing personnel and formations. They have Oklahoma on their heels defensively.
Perkins again, pin him to the boundary, and they do. He tries to angle right, finds a lane, but is hit again, right at the 17. Daniel McLemore, the defensive back, with a beautiful play. So first and 10, Oklahoma playing catch up in a big way on the road where they've had some very close games. Lost on the road. Their only loss of the year came on the road at A&M. Hybl in trouble. And a diving grab, but out of bounds as it's taken in on the near side. Making the grab was Will Peoples. Tried to get a foot down, the sophomore from Humble, Texas. The pressure had a lot to do with the errant throw.
Yeah, and Darren Williams is doing an excellent job on the field side of coverage. He's the field side. He's got the wide side of the football field because he's a better cover guy. And they have the young freshman, Vernon Grant, playing the boundary side, the short side of the field, less area to roam. I'll tell you what, the guy that is really stepping up is Darren Williams doing a great job in coverage early in this game.
Second and 10, Hybl again out of the gun, sliding his tight end. Counter for Griffin, slowed down to the backfield. Play busted up completely. Now what a job getting to him in the backfield. Kevin Williams slowed him down. He had the penetration. Richmond, Duren making the stop.
Kevin Williams was the disruptor on this play. First team, all Big 12, defensive lineman. Watch him come off the football and get into the backfield. The penetration's extreme. When you have to make your first cut in your own backfield, I don't care how good a back you are, and Quentin Griffin's a good one, when you have to make your first cut 3 or 4 yards in your own backfield, you're going to make a great run, just get back to the line of scrimmage.
Still third and 10. They just got their first down on a third and 3. Flood the left side with 3 wide receivers. Hybl with great pocket protection, wide open. He's got Peoples. He's got a first down inside the 45-yard line of the 42. Elbert Craig dropping him in the secondary. He had a few options to look at with that much time in the backfield.
Yeah, and what he did, he created some of his own time, Joel. Watch on the edge, Antonio Smith. He comes on the stunt. Hybl just slide steps away from him, and the pocket was secure otherwise. Once he slid step away from Antonio Smith, he's got plenty of time to get his eyes refocused down the football field. Little tackle and twist. Smith comes clean. Hybl sidesteps, resets his feet. Great throwing motion, completion.
Kewon Jones, little counter play up the middle. Slugging his way inside the 40, down to the 38. Gain of 4 for Jones.
Big drive here for Oklahoma, down 2 touchdowns. And have to answer.
Let's not forget, this is a senior quarterback, and he's got, coming into the game, an 18-2 record as a starter.
And really, they're so balanced offensively, Joel, it's not like they can't throw the football. Sometimes their passing game sets up the run, sometimes the running game sets up the pass. this early in the football game, you're not going to see game plans flying out of the coaching booth. They're not going to give up their game plan yet. Plenty of time.
They've got to run the football. That is going to be a key all day for Oklahoma. Jones, little crease, not much available. Maybe two down to the 36. It'll bring up a third and long, third and about four. Duren wrapped him up, the outside backer.
One thing that Oklahoma has done so much better this year has been able to run the football. Kevin Wilson, a big contributor to that. Oklahoma, Bob Stoops hired him away from Northwestern, where they ran the ball out of the shotgun very effectively. His offensive line's coming off the ball with a lot more attitude and intensity, and they're running the ball because they want to, you know, not because defenses are letting them, but now they're behind by 14 points. They're still going to have to mix it up.
Can they convert on a third down again? They hit on 45% during the regular season. Hybl, quick pop. It's complete. First down. Taking it in Curtis Fagan. As a gang tackle him around the 26-yard line.
That's the key. Great call there, Joel. Do you see how many guys are all around the football? Six or seven.
Well, coming into the game, Oklahoma's already wrapped up the Big 12 South Division regular season title. Next week in Houston, they're going to be the North champions, winners yesterday over Nebraska, the Buffaloes of Colorado. But Oklahoma State is already bowl eligible. Right. Now they can really increase, enhance their position for a better bowl.
No question. And boy, they really hate that. Look back on that Louisiana Tech loss early.
Griffin weaving his way. Nifty moves. They finally get to him, but there's not a lot to get to. We talked about it. Quentin Griffin's only 5'7", 190. Tough, fast, and as Bill played the defensive court. Jones, Runnels in the eye on a first down all the way to the 15. Drive started deep in Oklahoma territory. The fade, corner of the end zone. Jump ball, and it's knocked away. Great play, taking it away from Brandon Jones. It was Darren Williams.
Is that that's not a flag in the end zone, is it? Yeah, I guess it must be. They're talking about it. I saw something come out just about 2 yards into the end zone, and it is. They're calling pass interference on the play. Yeah, I thought that was decent coverage, but pass interference was the call. When that orange end zone, it's tough to pick up that yellow flag, but it's sitting there. And let's take a look. Boy, there's a little bit of it could go either way. Both guys have their head looking for the football. The left arm wrapped around. The left arm wrapped around the body is what the official called. And I'll tell you, I'm not sure it made a difference in the outcome of the play. But Darren Williams wraps that left arm around the body, and that left arm is what the official saw with that bear hug around the body and felt that it impeded his opportunity to catch.
He never turned around to really locate the ball, though, did he?
Well, in college football, you know, it's not as big a factor. That's not as big a problem with regard to the penalty call.
Juwan Jones, counter, give left, bangs up the middle. He's to the one. It'll be second and goal just outside of the one. Richmond finally gets to him. And the junior from Oklahoma City. And Robinson also in on the hit, the middle linebacker, senior from Tyler, Texas.
And this is where Oklahoma really, really struggled last year. Was running the football when you're first and goal inside the 5-yard line. And they feel like they can do it a lot better this year. And Griffin with that pad level low, but the challenge is met by Terrence Robinson. That was a good hit in the hole by a linebacker filling against a good, good running back.
Second and goal. Jones diving. Is he there? I thought he got in. No call yet. They're going to say he's inches away, but back to what you were talking about, Dave. In 12 games last year, the Sooners had 20 rushing touchdowns. In 11 games this year, they've already got 29.
Yeah, and I guess they felt that that time Griffin bounced into the end zone. He hit just short of the end zone and bounced in. Quarter ends at the 6-inch line.
And a shocker early, but the Sooners about to get on the board when we come back, barring a turnover. 14 to nothing at the end of the first 15 minutes of play. Water's got to be chilly, but nobody's complaining. Oklahoma and Oklahoma State. From Lewis Field, Joel Myers, Dave Lapman, Eric Clemens down on the sideline. Had a 14 to nothing lead, believe it or not, but Oklahoma's starting to put it together. They started this drive back at their own 17-yard line. Now they've got third and goal just inches away. And we were just talking about the way they have been able to get the ball in the end zone this year on the ground. They have not had to be the deceptive team over the last couple of years like they were in play fakes and throwing the ball. So let's see if they can hammer it home. It'll be Jones coming from the sideline along with J.D. Runnels.
This is their power formation right here, much more physical.
Jones, airborne, he's in. Touchdown, Sooners.
That's his 14th touchdown rushing of the season. He is their short yardage goal line guy. Nice body lean, easy touchdown. Nice blocking up front.
Let's also remind everybody, Oklahoma State got off to a 10-0 lead early in the season against UCLA, and UCLA came back with 31 unanswered points on the same field.
And in the opener, the game that Oklahoma State probably looks back on and shakes their head, they had a 17-point lead on Louisiana Tech in the third quarter and lost the game by a point.
Trey DiCarlo with the extra point, and he pushed it.
Yep.
He pushed it. He'd already missed two this year. He's missed a third now. That hurts. After that kind of drive, 83 yards. Failed in the conversion, but the Sooners are on the board, and it's an 8-point deficit for Oklahoma. Welcome back to Stillwater. As DiCarlo just missed the extra point, Dan Cody is going to kick it away. And now Oklahoma State on a very short kick. Coming up to take it, it's going to be Chris Matthews buried. And Bryant instead, T.D. Bryant. Dennison did a number on him. Now Tatum Bell into the secondary. He's got a first down. Well, they're going to put him maybe short by about a foot. He landed on the 40. They're going to put him shy of the 39 in the arms of Brandon Everidge.
He's really, really improved his toughness at the running back position. He keeps a nice low pad level down. Much stronger with that 12-pound gain. He's much more durable.
Well, Miami dominating Syracuse up at the Carrier Dome, 35-7. So it doesn't look like Oklahoma, even if they win today, doesn't look like they're going to get any help from Syracuse. It'll have to come from Virginia Tech.
Yeah, their primary concern right now is the Cowboys in those orange jerseys. They're playing well.
Josh Fields on second and inches, toss sweep. Bell tripped up, but still getting the first down to the 40. Derek Strait got him low.
I think Oklahoma State's offensive line is doing a nice job at the line of scrimmage. That Oklahoma defense is very, very fast, and the best way to anchor them is to run right at them. And the boys up front coming off the ball pretty well.
And you've got serious experience on the outside, those two tackles, Russell, the senior, and Kyle Eaton, the senior.
And Kyle Eaton, big number 65 right there, the big left tackle. 6'8", 300 pounds, one of six Division I-A athletes to get a College Football National Scholar Athlete Award. $10,000 for his postgraduate work.
On the play fake, Fields wanted to go deep. And he's got his man open again.
Wow.
At the 20-yard line. Rashaun Woods, touchdown Oklahoma State.
Unbelievable. For the second time this season, Bob Stoops can't believe his eyes. Texas A&M was raining touchdown passes on the Sooners. Four touchdown passes in that game, two touchdown passes already early in this one. Rashaun Woods over the top from long distance twice.
Walker for the point after. It's good. So now, all of a sudden, three early scores, 260-yarders to Woods. Play fake worked again,
yep.
And the Cowboys are dominating early in the second quarter. Rashaun Woods has just established a new Cowboys single-season mark with his 15th touchdown reception. This young man has put together phenomenal numbers all year long. He came in today with nine straight games, Dave, of seven or more catches.
I have a question. How can he not be a Biletnikoff finalist? He's in the top four in the nation in
good
catches
question.
Per game, top 5 yards per game. How is he not a finalist?
Very good question. Farden keeps it on the ground. And it's going to be brought back by Antoine Savage. Across the 25, belted, going down near the 27. Hybl with Griffin in the backfield. Slide Smith to tight end and come back the other way with Griffin. He just powers his way across the 30, up to the 33. Gain of about 6 on first down. Eric Clemens, what's the latest?
Well, we talk about Rashaun Woods, guys, and earlier this season, some coaches, opponents, and things wondered whether Rashaun was physical enough to come up big time. Well, he responded in that game we had earlier here on Fox Sports Net against UCLA with a yes. He was dominant last season against Oklahoma. He's been dominant throughout the last 2 years. He set single season records, as you talked about, 86 catches and 1,305 yards coming in. I think he's the real deal, guys.
I guess
he's got the size, doesn't he? It's Griffin. Man, boy, was that a slow developing play. Coming in from the outside, Paul Duren. What a start the outside linebackers had. He's only a redshirt freshman from Dell City, Oklahoma. And it's a loss of about a half a yard. It's going to be 3rd and 4, almost 5.
And it's contagious. I mean, the absolute atmosphere is electric here. Oklahoma State, all phases of it are just all jacked up. The adrenaline is pumping, and Oklahoma's stunned. I mean, you know, they just, right now, they're just puzzled, and Bob Stoops can't figure it out either. Can't believe his football team's playing this way early on.
You just don't do this to the Sooners defensive unit. And especially in a quarter and a couple of minutes, they fire the slant. It's packed away from the wide receiver, Will Peoples. Punched away by Durant Williams.
He's playing a very solid football game. And the coverage has been outstanding. I mean, the route recognition is phenomenal. It's like they're in the huddle. And they're hearing the routes are going to be run. The coverage is so tight. When even if catches are made by Oklahoma, Oklahoma State is tackling immediately. No yards after catch.
Gabe Lindsey waiting for the punt. Once again from Blake Ferguson. So the third time the Sooners have gone 3 and out with a punt. They get into the end zone with that 83-yard drive on their other possession. And Lindsey puts it on the ground, gets it back with flags on the play. Still isn't down across the 30 to the 35. There's going to be a Hybl violation, I believe, against Oklahoma. Let's remind everybody, Dave, Oklahoma's 4th best in scoring defense. They only give up 14 points a game.
Exactly.
Fields has his man all tangled up. He was trying to get it to Billy Badgett at the tight end. Working against Derek Strait and fighting downfield.
Well, that's not a matchup that's favorable to the Cowboys. You have your tight end on your best cover guy. Derek Strait's the best cover guy for Oklahoma. Although you have a size mismatch to Badgema, which is dramatic, but he had no separation whatsoever. Badgema is 6'5", 250, running down the football field against a defensive back, 5'11", 194 pounds.
How about the average per completion for Josh Fields? 122 yards, 4 completions.
I thought his completion average was big against Baylor last week, 24 yards per completion. I mean, it's bigger today.
Fields after another play fake. Deep down the middle. Unbelievable. It is the tight end. Will he go the distance? Badgema fighting down to the 10-yard line. Bassey saves the touchdown. Well, the middle of the field working quite nicely.
Yep. Everidge missed the tackle, and what they caught Oklahoma in that time was cover two. And the safeties working their way out. Watch the safeties working their way out to help against the wide receivers. Vacating the middle of the field, that's where you bring the big tight end in there. And against cover two, Badgema gets down the middle of the football field well. Everidge misses the tackle. Woolfolk has to make the play. They just found the big tight end right down the chute against cover two. Big, big play.
Have you ever thought about abstract art?
Nobody home. Yeah.
So it's just outside of the 11. We have seen, I mean, every game it seems has gone down to the wire for us this year. Not this one right now, though. It's early. Bending the boundary, Tatum Bell was lucky to only lose a yard out of that play. Dan Cody chasing him down, the sophomore from Ada, Oklahoma.
You see Oklahoma's team speed right there. Everybody on their feet. Nobody get knocked to the ground. There was no cutback lane. They all pursued inside out and gang tackled. Great speed.
Big guy at 6'5", 270 pounds. So the Cowboys dominating one of the best defensive units in the nation. Both teams coming off highs last week. A win for Oklahoma for Texas Tech. And the Cowboys scored 60-plus as well on Baylor. So plenty of momentum. It still belongs to the Cowboys, though. Fields with time, corner of the end zone. Touchdown, Rashaun Woods. What an amazing start to the day for Rashaun Woods. His third touchdown catch, his 16th of the season. And we're only midway through the second quarter.
Yeah, this is a complete day for a lot of people, particularly against a team like Oklahoma. They got the matchup by formation they wanted again. Woods on Wolfolk and his precise route running ability fooled Wolfolk again. He bit inside, Woods took it outside.
Luke Phillips, the point after. A day of perfection so far. It's Seniors Day for the Cowboys of Oklahoma State, and they couldn't have asked for a better first half. They have dominated their rivals from just about an hour, hour and a half away with a 22-point lead at the half. Let's head downstairs to Eric Clemens. Eric.
Coach Miles, it seems like just about everything is going your way on both sides of the football. Your assessment of your team's first half performance?
They're playing well. It's just halftime. We're in a hell of a ball game. We're going to play like hell.
Okay, good enough, Coach. Good luck to you in the second half. Do not adjust your sets, folks. Oklahoma State leading fourth-ranked Oklahoma at the half, 28-6 here at Lewis Field. They're for real, at least for a half. We're back here with the Nissan Halftime Report in just a moment.
Cowboys have everything going their way. They won the toss, deferred to the second half, and now they're going to receive the kick to begin the second 30 minutes of play. T.D. Bryant back deep along with Chris Massey. Well hit. Massey will take it about 8 yards into the end zone. Cowboys have it first and 10 of their own 20. Eric, how do the Sooners feel, and especially Bob Stoops?
Well, Bob Stoops, as you can imagine, Joel, is pretty disappointed. He told me a few words. We just simply have to execute better. Think that might mean double teaming number 82 if you're on the defensive side for Oklahoma, guys? I think so.
Yeah, they'll probably put bracket coverage. There's no doubt about that, but you can't bite on those play fakes, and they did that.
Well, I think, and Eric, you make a good point, and I think if they do bracket Rashaun Woods, you'll see Oklahoma State run the football, which they'll probably do a little bit with a 22-point lead anyway.
Tandem Bell is the single in the backfield behind Josh Fields, who was 8 for 12 in the first half for 237 yards. So much for running the football. There's the bracket and almost intercepted. They went for T.D. Bryant. They had double coverage. Wolfolk should have come up with the interception.
Yeah, up on the other side of the football field, straight, had great coverage. So they put T.D. Bryant on Wolfolk in this matchup, and the coverage was pretty good. I'll tell you, if they are going to play cover two like that and help have the safety help from the middle of the football field help the corners, I think you see Oklahoma State run the ball, and I think you see Badgham with a big tight end down the middle again.
Second and 10. They'll counter it over to the right side. Bell tripped up. It looked like he was going to have a big game. Derek Strait gets to him. It's a gain of 4. It'll be 3rd and 6.
Yeah, it looked like he slipped to the turf as he tried to make that violent cut. Something I could never think about doing. You know, you try to make a cut like these guys do these days. Ligament and cartilage strewn all over the field.
There's the slide you're talking about on the last play. Otherwise, I think he might get the first down.
Yeah, he just slipped sliding away, got on the edge of his skis and lost control.
So a 3rd and 6.
Here they come.
Showing the blitz up the middle. It's picked up, fired on the slant, complete to Woods. First down again to the 33. Rashaun Woods with another grab. That's his 7th of the day.
Incredible. Rashaun Woods has been a factor over the top. Play action fakes. And Rashaun Woods has just run by people. Wolfolk is the guy in particular that he's matched up against. And that time he beat Wolfolk and Baskey to the football. And tell you what, this one's just a great route. I mean, he just turned Wolfolk around. And he gave the football to Eric Clemens on the sideline right there after that third touchdown reception.
He's now got 93 catches on the year. As Bell spins, bangs, and gets it out to the 38 for a gain of 5. But back to Rashaun Woods. He's already topped the single season mark, held by Hartley Dice, leading the Big 12 with better than 8 catches a game. Tops of the Big 12, receiving yardage, better than 118 a contest. And I talked about it. Now it's 10 straight games, a measure of consistency. 10 straight with 7 or more catches.
That's the thing. Week in and week out, this guy is probably the hardest working wide receiver in college football. And he's going to give effort every single snap at the top of the screen on this particular play.
Call it 2nd and long 5, almost 6. Fields automatizing, changing the play at the line from the 38. And single coverage. He wants to go outside, and he does again to Woods for a first down. What a read. by the quarterback because he had one-on-one for Woods.
And it was against Strait, the best cover man, and they ran the fade. You can run the fade at any point of the field. Strait's got great inside coverage, turns to find the ball, perfect throw by Fields to the sideline, and he takes Woods right to that sideline, great throw. And earlier, the snap before, Strait beats Woods. Strait is Woods' assignment in that running play, and he took a bad approach and never laid a glove on Strait. So he's trying to be the complete wide receiver. We've seen him throw some good blocks today, not on that one.
Bell with a seal to the outside. Bell into the secondary, gets nine, call it eight on first down. Perkins possibly saves the touchdown.
You mentioned it at the top of the broadcast, Joel. Josh Fields is a sophomore. Rashaun Woods is a junior. And these guys are in such sync. And their timing is so incredible. They got another full year to enjoy each other. They're going to put up some serious numbers here in Cowboy annals that'll be tough to break.
Throw Tatum Bell in there. He's a junior. Then Seymour Shaw is only a sophomore.
And other than the offensive tackles, they're very young inside, and the offensive line gaining great experience as well.
Second, a little more than a yard. Fields changing up again at the line. Talk about a kid with confidence. Will it pay off? Quick out. Woods is there. Knocked out of bounds inside the 15. He realized the slot man had single coverage. That meant Woods did on the boundary.
And Wilfork knew he had Woods, and he gave Woods about a 10-yard cushion.
So the drive starts back at the Cowboys 20, and they pick up right where they left off at the first half. They've almost got 400 yards of total offense. 379 and counting.
And the yards per play is off the chart. Phenomenal.
It'll be Bell. No, a play fake. Middle, deflected, touchdown. You know things are going well. The tight end, Charlie Johnson.
Went right through the hands of the linebacker, Lance Mitchell. I mean, it was right in his hands. It goes through his hands and right into the receiver's breadbasket. Underthrown a little bit. Mitchell gets up, gets his hands on it. Right through those hands. And secured for the touchdown. You're right. When it rains, it pours. Charlie Johnson, the beneficiary.
Luke Phillips for the point after. And this is hard to believe.
It really is. Amazing.
Oklahoma State by 29. So Mitchell read it well. Did everything but knock it down and intercept it. Team of Savage and Perkins waiting for the kick from Phillips. In fact, Cole Pardon will kick it away. Not Phillips. Low line drive over to the near side. And Savage will bring it back. Antoine Savage tripped up across the 20. Only out to the 23. Taking it across the 25. Griffin gets it out to the 30-yard line. It's a gain of 7 on first down. Robinson finally got to him, the middle linebacker. So you don't want to quit and give up on the running game completely. But almost 4 minutes by the time you snap it gone in the third quarter.
That's the other key. If Oklahoma State can play keep away and continue to score points, there's nothing that Oklahoma's offense can do. They can't score enough to get back in the football game.
Oklahoma State scored on all but two of their drives. In the first half, one was a missed field goal. Swing to Griffin. He's got the first down. And he's across the 40-yard line. Going out of bounds with the first down into his own 43. Darren Williams shoved him there.
Well, the thing that the coaches say about Quentin Griffin is the most unselfish guy on the football team. The first one to practice, the last one to leave. Bob Stoops said, seven or eight games into his freshman year, I asked him to give up his red shirt. We had to have that done to finish the season the way we wanted to go to a bowl game, potential bowl game. Griffin gave it up for the good of the team. And that's been his trademark his whole career, unselfish.
The unpredictability of college football on display today. Nobody could have expected this. There's a hold. Hybl gets it away, and it's a trap. Could have been a hold call, but it won't be. He wanted Will Peoples down the middle. As the rush end on the outside beat the right tackle.
Yeah, Greg Richmond was talking to the official, saying, I can't believe you're not going to call that. And it was a takedown. It's like a wrestling takedown rather than a pass protection.
So now second and 10 from the 43. Hybl's got 19 attempts. Before it's all over, he'll have close to 40 today. That's a given. He's Griffin. He is pushed backwards. He needed three, and he didn't get there. Llewellyn Brown and Pinson got him low.
And Coach Barnett referenced the emotion with which Oklahoma State's playing. And that's the problem that Oklahoma saw with this, is that they have to get up for this game, get up for the Big 12 championship game, then, you know, potentially a BCS scenario. And that's a lot to ask of the kids. So they wanted to get back into that regular rotation, and we'll see how it all shakes down.
Third and a little more than two. 2.5 yards for the first down. Probably four down territory just about anywhere lately. They've got it. They've also got Mark Clayton. Good yardage across the midfield stripe to the 46-yard line. Clayton, the sophomore from Arlington, Texas.
You know, when you think about this matchup, you would think big plays. You know, who's capable of the big plays? All the athletes that Oklahoma has, you would think they were going to be the big play team coming in, and Oklahoma State would have to stop the big play potential. They have. But not only that, Oklahoma State, Rashaun Woods and company, have made a bunch of big plays. They have had the explosive plays today, not Oklahoma.
So multiple substitutions as Kewon Jones, their power back, takes over in the eye. Hybl to the play fake, wants to go deep. His man fell down, gets up and almost took it in.
Dropped it.
Brandon Jones looked back, and all of a sudden it was in his arms. He's a sophomore, off balance, and that hurt him when he finally recovered.
Yeah, and you look at the shadows, the way the shadows are projecting, the sun may have been a factor as well.
Quentin Griffin, the Dr. Pepper, Big 12 Player of the Week, has returned into the backfield, flanking Nate Hybl on the option. It is Griffin coming off a 207-yard rushing day last week. And he's pushed out of bounds with a first down and a flag at the end of the play where you normally see a guy around the face mask.
Antoine Savage, the wide receiver, had a great block. Took the Oklahoma State defender to the turf, giving Quentin Griffin a lane.
Just a defense, 5 yards to the end of the run, first down.
Not the major one, didn't tackle him by the face mask, got the hand up in the headgear. Great block right there that had the defender down. And boy, is it in the face mask. Oh yeah, just a little bit at the end as he raked across the shoulder pads. That's 5 yards, if anything. I think that's a leave alone, but they did get 5 yards out of it.
Jones takes over, and then Griffin shoved to the ground.
It's hard to get low enough on a guy 5'7".
A little punishment at the end of that play, as we could see with his helmet bouncing back up. Hybl going into the end zone. Man, just out of the reach of Brandon Jones.
Caught it.
And he did get it. Unbelievable.
Yeah. One-handed.
He got
grab.
It with the one hand. He put out the left hand. Fed it off the defender. A brilliant catch. I didn't think there was any way, Dave. And going away from us in the other corner, Brandon Jones came up with it.
And the sun is in his eyes. Look at the shadows at a 45-degree angle. Sun in his eyes, he makes a one-handed catch with that left hand. Tremendous play by Jones. Great effort.
It comes with 4:20 left in the third quarter. They've got to go for two after the botched extra point try by DiCarlo. Their only touchdown so far. So now can they draw back within 21 points? And they don't have enough men on the field, believe it or not. Will they be able to get it off? Yes, they should. There's still 10 on the play clock.
Griffin checking in late.
Spread the defense. They bunch him on the right side. Look at Griffin on the left. He was available instead. It's over the middle, and it's good. He's got Peoples for the two-point conversion.
That's
you
nice
never
play.
Know.
Yeah.
Three touchdown deficit for the Sooners with 4:20 left in the third 15. Unbelievable catch. Well, was it a catch? We're going to go back and look at this 35-14 ball game. Chris Massey and T.D. Bryant wait for it. It'll be Massey from the three. Now cut a field position for the Cowboys. He's got a lane. And then it closes in a hurry as he tumbles down across the 25 and the 26. You be the judge. I thought it hit the turf.
Well, here's the official. And watch. He stays back. Left hand. Tip. Brings it in. It does hit the turf. That you can't see from that angle. Can't see it. There's the ball on the turf. See, the ball's on the turf. The ball helps him. Now, this is the better angle. The official gets his body blocked. The body blocks. He doesn't see the ball hit the ground right there. Ball's out on the ground. The ball helps him. Ground helps him secure the catch. Should have been ruled no catch.
So now the Cowboys moving the pocket. Bajima again. That was the one he caught, the 58-yarder. And it's thrown away. It wasn't intercepted. Picked off by Wolfolk, but out of bounds.
Yep.
So Fields out of the pocket needs to throw it away when you've got a 21-point lead in your own territory as opposed to just throwing it near the boundary.
Well, Oklahoma was looking for a spark. Did Brandon Jones' questionable, controversial catch give him that spark? Let's see how close Wolfolk came. Catch. Lowell, left foot in, right foot out. He had the catch, and the left foot was in. He tapped. I'll tell you what, he tapped that sideline. Just need to get one down in college football, and he did it. He got the left foot down. That's two in a row.
Well, I think I just saw the challenge flag go out.
Yeah, right.
Second and 10.
No can do.
The ball at the 26.
Great play.
The toss. Tatum Bell beaten alive at the 30-yard line. Boy, there's some punishing hits still in this ball game. He did get that left foot. He doubted it, didn't he?
Absolutely. You watch Wolfolk. You only need to get 1 foot down in college football. Ball's airborne. Catch. Watch his left foot. Down. Possession. Foot down. Catch. Big time. Should be an interception. Not ruled that way.
And now a big third down all of a sudden. Clock is moving. Third and 6. You better keep up with the number 82, or Rashaun Woods. He's next to T.D. Bryant. They put two to each side. They're to the wide side of the field. Fields, with time, finds his man for the first down. He's across the 37 to the 38. Taking it in, it was Rashaun Woods. Eric Bassey got to him quickly, but good throw.
Yeah, the thing that Fields is doing so well, Joel, is he's seeing the field so much better as the season has progressed, and he's doing both of the A's much better. Anticipation and accuracy. Throwing the ball with anticipation, you have to against a fast defensive football team. Throw it almost before your receivers come out of their cuts, which he's done, and he's been accurate with those deliveries. That's a tough combination.
Two to the wide side on first down. And they still want to throw the football, and they want to go deep. Rashaun Woods out of his reach inside the 5, working against Andre Wolfolk. 35-14, inside of 2 minutes to play in the third. Bell bolting his way, close to a first down, shy by a yard at the 39.
And this is the Bell that the Oklahoma State coaching staff was talking about. With less than 2 minutes to go in the third quarter, he's got the endurance now and the durability to be a factor into the fourth quarter when he's tired.
You know, it was like the coaches told us last year, it was like he was playing at mile-high elevation.
Right.
He was out of gas at the fourth quarter of games.
Right, but he's built up his endurance. He's gained 12 pounds. He's stronger. He's breaking tackles. He's a factor in the fourth quarter, whereas in prior games, he had kind of checked out of it by then.
18 carries, 83 yards today for Tatum Bell. Now third and a yard. Will the drive stay alive? Fields wants to throw for it. He's waiting for Woods. Finally gets hit. Scrambling. He won't get there. Sack for the loss. Back at the 42. You have to think a punt is coming up for the Cowboys.
You got to start thinking field position here. And, you know, not only the clock, Joel, but make him go a long way, multiple plays. And in this game, turnover free for the most part. I mean, it's been very, very well played. The ball's been on the ground a couple of times, but haven't lost possession. And coming in, that was a big factor because Oklahoma plus 17 in the turnover department. Oklahoma State, great ball security today.
They've held onto the ball for better than 4 minutes. Bad snap. Perkins waiting for the punt from Farden. That was out of sync for the beginning.
Well, that's because Jed Newkirk, remember, he got hurt.
Yes.
Hurt that knee in the first half, and the second deep snapper nowhere near as effective. That thing rolled back there.
So it was only a 4-yard punt. And now a break for Oklahoma. A very short field with 23 seconds left in the third quarter. Can they capitalize? It's the number 3 team of the nation on the verge of a major upset, trailing by 21 to their arch rivals. Time for Hybl, and it's a low throw at the feet of Curtis Fagan. And it looked like he had pretty decent pocket protection and a lane to see.
He did. I agree with you. I didn't think his vision was obscured whatsoever. Just held on to the ball a little too long. And it hit him right in the hoof.
So now second and 10. Savage has very few touches today. He came in as their leading receiver. In the slot on the short side of the field, Hybl out of the gun with two to each side. Little dump off, won't do much, and that'll be the final play as I brought up Antoine Savage. That's not what he was looking for. Terrence Robinson all over. So that is going to be the end of the third quarter. Cowboys still in control of the Sooners, 35-14. You're watching College Football Saturday presented by Kyocera on Fox Sports Net. College Football Saturday presented by Kyocera. Welcome to back to Oklahoma. What a great show. Still like seeing that. And we are in Stillwater. The Cowboys ready to ride into the sunset. I think they'll take the gal with them tonight. I think they'll take anything they want, actually. Dominating the Sooners since the opening play. And now the Sooners on a third and long, third and eight. Hybl in trouble. Eludes Mitchell. Can he get the first down? No. He's short by a yard and a half. They've got to go for it, though, trailing by 21. Paul Duren, the redshirt freshman. Dell City, Oklahoma, making the hit.
There haven't been any turnovers in the football game, but when Oklahoma has gone for it on fourth down already this game and didn't convert, and if they don't convert here, it's as good as a turnover because you get that short field like Oklahoma State enjoyed when they held Oklahoma the other time on fourth down.
The Sooners have done so well in Big 12 play, they just don't know what it's like to be in this position. 25-6 in Big 12 games under Bob Stoops. Now, Hybl, after the play fake, he can run for it, I believe, and he will.
Just
see the spot. Yes, he's got it across the 49.
He's got a turf burn to show for it, too.
So first down, right at the midfield strike. Move the chains.
Good call. Little naked bootleg, little fake run inside. It sucked everybody into the middle of the football field and got Hybl on the edge. Gutsy call. But there's one thing that Bob Stoops does not lack, it's guts. We've seen him make some incredible calls over the years.
Hybl out of the gun on first down. Got to get a touchdown. You don't know how many more possessions you're going to get. Maybe three. Griffin down the sideline. Big first down. Stopping the clock, using the sideline to the 33. Microsoft game summary. Well, it all started 3-for-3 for the Cowboys at Oklahoma State. Three touchdowns on their first three possessions. Rashaun Woods, Big 12 leader, fourth in the nation. And catches per game. He's got 10 today for over 200 yards, three touchdowns. Fields pretty efficient. 14 for 318. Take that all day long.
His yards per completion are phenomenal.
A yard shy of 2-for-1 in total yards offensively. Dave, 435 to 218.
Yards per attempt, yards per completion, amazing.
Now, single coverage on the outside and the ball out of the reach. Wide receiver, Curtis Fagan. Darren Williams. Doing a good job again. They've really gone after Williams. He's been involved since the first couple of snaps.
Well, he has, and he's risen to the occasion. And they've gone to him because he's the wide side of the field. You know, they put their young freshman, Vernon Grant, into the boundary, the short side of the field. So they ask a lot out of Williams. He's got two interceptions on the season. Didn't have any today, but, boy, he has provided tight coverage for the most part.
The numbers for Hybl.
Not bad.
Running the option with Griffin. Cut off at the pass. Still makes something out of nothing. He's incredible. Down to the 21st down Oklahoma. The balance again where he looks like his knee might be going down, right, but he's not out of the play.
Right, he's got that left arm that he puts down and forms the tripod to keep his balance. He gets himself upright and off he goes. Incredible balance. Very, very tough to knock off his feet. You get him in the open field with the pitch. Now you're in trouble because you make him miss it. Put that left hand down and then get up the field immediately. I mean, as soon as he rights himself, boom, he's north and south now.
Approaching 13 minutes, the blitz coming, a hold. Let's see if there's a flag, and it's overthrown, trying to get it to Mark Clayton. Boy, that was almost a takedown in the line. It looked like it could have been the tight end, Lance Donnelly, grabbing Chris Massey, the safety coming in.
And you know, Quentin Griffin, 5'7", 190 pounds, he has to pick up blitzers, and he did on that time, that occasion, very well. He's not bashful. You know what? In blocking, low man wins. So when he sets up at 5'7", it's tough to get under his pads.
They have been letting them play. Not a lot of flags today. And now second and 10 from the 20. Sooners get a break. Griffin, misdirection. Tripped up down to the 16-yard line. A gain of four. Third down from there. They need six. Vernon Grant, the run support for the quarterback. He's a true freshman out of Duncanville, Texas.
Nice block that time by one of the young incoming stars for Oklahoma, Davin Joseph. He's a freshman, high school freshman, or a freshman.
Well, we
just
hope
out,
not.
Just out of high school.
It's an extension program.
A true freshman now, Joel. He's a wrestler, tremendous balance, long arms, great player.
On third down, Hybl looks one way, comes back the other way, and he's got the first down. Mark Clayton. And no, he's not. I thought he was going to get inside the 10. He's tripped up at the 13. So it's going to be fourth and three. Have to go for it, trailing by three scores. And 3 minutes just about gone in the fourth.
You mentioned
so this is basically the ball game. You can face it because you're only going to get a couple more possessions probably. 35-14 Oklahoma State. What about Hybl on the edge again with an option?
Oh, Trent Smith. There he is.
Down the middle, touchdown, Oklahoma. Trent Smith, you called it, partner.
Yeah, he was in the slot, and he's a red zone target. The big All-American tight end. He's a load. He made himself available that time. 6'5", 230 pounds. He's more of a slot receiver than a tight end, truly, and they found him for the big score on fourth and three.
So now the potential is there for the Sooners. They need DiCarlo, who missed earlier, to split the uprights. And he does. So a brand new ball game. 14-point deficit for the Sooners. It's the closest they've been since late in the first quarter. 35-21 Cowboys.
Here's Trent Smith in the slot. Watch him come off the line of scrimmage in this little swim move he gets to release. And then watch Hybl thread the needle. Watch the swim move as he comes off the line of scrimmage. Whoop, swim inside. Now he's got to keep his balance. Hybl threads the needle. Touchdown, Trent Smith in the slot. Nice play.
Dan Cody to kick it away for the Sooners. They're only down by 14. Massey to the near side. T.D. Bryant over to the far side. And it's going to be taken by Bryant in front of Massey. Good communication there. Over to the left side, past the 20. Spinning to the 25, and that'll do it. Very crisp afternoon in Stillwater, Oklahoma. About 50 degrees at kickoff. Here in the shade, it feels about 30. In the sun, close to 50. And now first and 20. Bryant got the block. Outside the 30, up to the 34. And giving up his body again was John Lewis, so he could get 9 yards.
That was Rashaun Woods, and you know, the throw that Fields made right there, he hit Woods in stride. How many times we've seen Hybl make his receiver stop to catch it or reach behind him to catch it? And that time Fields put the ball out in front. And that's a tough throw to make as accurately as he did. And he did it without any problem. And Woods comes off the field limping after making that catch when he went to the turf, a definite hitching to get along.
He'll take the snap right at the 9 minute mark on second and 11. Need to go across the 45, near the 46. Fields, pocket protection's there. A bullet. He's got a first down. Lewis came back to get it. Won't get the mark for the first down, actually. He's right at the 45, about a foot shy in the arms of Teddy Lehman. But again, displaying a gun was Josh Fields.
And throwing with so much anticipation and putting it on the money. I mean, the ball's in the air before his receiver comes out of the cut. Bryant, semi-roll behind the right tackle, throws it back across the grain a little bit, and just makes a throws a dart. I mean, an absolute dart. Teddy Lehman, in coverage.
So now, adjustments for Oklahoma State. They go with the unbalanced line. Let's see if they go top-heavy the same way they did. Yes, they do. There you go, your flying wedge you were looking for.
Yeah, scrumming it up.
Josh Fields, quarterback sneak. He's across the 45. It's going to depend again. And the way the linesman was running in, I think he got it again.
Yeah.
14-point lead for the Cowboys. Oklahoma has scored the last two times they've had it.
Watch Denard here. Now, technically, you're not supposed to push from behind, and he's just got Fields. Now, what you have to do is be a good actor, and have the official think you're just blocking. He's not blocking. He's hiking Fields over the line of scrimmage right there, and you're not supposed to help a player thrust forward with impetus like that.
Unusual angle to block from.
Yeah, most definitely.
First and 10.
Is that Fields' better side?
Close to the 46. And they'll give the options to the running back.
Man.
What a torpedo that was. Wolf. Andre Wolfel. And he took the worst of it, I think.
They're both hurt. They're both
Shaw's getting up slowly, too. 7:43 left, and good news. It looks like a bloody nose for Andre Wolfel. He's up and moving over to the sideline. This was the knee of the helmet.
The right knee as it comes up. Watch the right knee. Boom. Right on the helmet. And sometimes the helmet comes down on the bridge of the nose. As he takes that kind of contact, the helmet shifts, the face mask goes down by your chin, and the bridge of the top of the helmet hits right across the bridge of the nose. It looked like they were applying pressure on his nose to try to stop some bleeding. So hopefully that was the biggest reason that he was down.
Fields out of the gun on second and long. He released Tatum Bell down the middle of the field, and if he throws it long enough, he had beaten Lance Mitchell.
Right. That's another way to beat cover two. When the safeties vacate the middle of the field to go to the sidelines to help the corners on the wide receivers, you can put your tight end down the middle like they did with Badgema, or you can run your tailback out of the backfield down the hash mark against the linebacker, and they had it. They had Tatum Bell, but as you described, Josh Fields a little bit short on the throw, and Mitchell was able to recover and make a play on the football.
So now third and 11. What do? You run it? Take another 30, 40 seconds off the clock?
No. Bassey.
Pressure from the outside. First down catch. Who else? Rashaun Woods adding to his record-setting total today, his 12th reception of the day.
That time you get matched up with Perkins. It doesn't matter who they match him up with. Nobody's a match for him. His routes are so precise and so perfect, and he's done it so many times that he could do it in his sleep. And the separation that he gets is phenomenal. And Fields puts it right on the money.
So that'll take it down to about 5 minutes if they hold on to the football. And the chances, very slim for the Sooners. They cannot get the... It's a simple game of keep away, and we've seen it before. Bell to the backfield on first and 10. Bell getting the blocks he needs in the secondary. Another first down for the 26. More and more, they're simply wearing down the Oklahoma front.
Well, the guy that had the key block here is Denard, the fullback. Watch him with the block. Denard inside, boom. Nice little trap right there, and then the lane take advantage of. Pancake block. I mean, you get people on the ground, they can't make tackles. Oklahoma State decimating the interior of the Oklahoma defense on that snap.
45,000, maybe 1,000 Sooner fans here. 45,000 overall, and these Cowboy fans, they are not leaving early. Now you just want to hand it off and chew up the clock. Bell looking for the crease. Gets it inside the 25 to the 24. Eric Levins.
All right, Joel, talk about Tatum Bell. What a difference health makes. Battled all kinds of nagging injuries earlier in the season. Limited to 33 carries and 168 yards his first six games. Coming into this afternoon, the last five games, 107 carries, 662 yards, and 8 touchdowns. That is a huge difference and, of course, a big contribution running the football and being elusive and powerful today, helping out that Oklahoma State offense and that play action, helping Rashaun Woods get open and run free all game long.
No doubt about it, Eric. I mean, one, you know, it's the glove fitting the hand. You're right.
Bell won't turn the corner, but he stays in bounds. And if you're Oklahoma, you got to think about, when am I going to use my timeouts? Teddy Lehman, weak side backer, he's been all over the place. And I'm cold just with watching that shot.
I'm telling you what.
A lot of antifreeze in those young men.
Pumping through those veins is antifreeze.
Shaw's back into the game, trying to get out of an ankle tackle on third. At about 9, And a timeout is going to be called by Oklahoma. So the Sooners use their first. 4:14 to play. And right now, a field goal would wrap it up. This will ice it. 40 yards away. He missed a 43-yarder early. To go up by 17. And that should do it.
Yes.
The Cowboys should be able to celebrate because now it's more than just two touchdowns and two two-point conversions for the Sooners. Luke Phillips, who did a number on the Sooners last year with 252 yarders in the 16-13 win, comes through again for Les Miles. Well, your wishes have been granted. Santa has come through. The Pokes in the 97th edition of the Bedlam Series. Taking care of the Sooners early and often with three touchdowns before the Sooners knew what hit them. Antonio or Antoine Savage going back with Antonio Perkins.
Well, the field goal was big. 14 plays and 7:37 is even bigger. That's keep away at its best at an important time. And then to finish it with 3 points was monumental.
Cole Farton to kick it away. He's had a workout today. And he is juiced up right out of the end zone. Beautiful football weather. And now just about a half hour, 45 minutes from sunset. Stillwater, Oklahoma. What a night it's going to be for these Pokes. Grab his man, but he can't get to the sideline. Will Peoples tried to get to the boundary to stop the clock. Vernon Grant corralled him around the ankles. So the hurry up offense inside of four to play.
Yeah, it's not going to be real still in Stillwater tonight, boy. The play's going to be rocking.
Second and four. Hybl has Savage first down. He'll stop it momentarily to move the chains at the 36. They'll give him the 6 and 7 yarders. That's not a problem.
Yep, because it eats that clock up. Now that it stops to move the chains in college football, but they'll give out those little chunks. They don't want to give up one over the top.
Hybl in trouble. Underneath, Quentin Griffin.
Wow.
He can make a miss, and he moves the chains again. In the open field, he's a lot of fun to watch. To the 48-yard line, Llewellyn Brown finally on his back.
I swear I could chase him for 10 minutes in a phone booth and never touch him.
Be a lot of fun to watch, though, Dave. I know that. Just thinking of that scenario.
You have a visual.
The completion to Mark Clayton short at about 8 yards. Can't get to the sideline again. So it's going to be inside of 3 minutes to play. So the final 3 minutes of our Big 12 season on Fox Sports Net. And what a year it has been. We have had some amazing games. It seems like everyone has gone down to the wire. Hybl for the tight end. He's got a first down inside the 20. Trent Smith taking it to the 19. The executive producer of Fox Sports Net is Bill Borson. Coordinating producers of College Football Saturday, Roy Hamilton, Gary Garcia. Today's game produced by Mike Kelling, directed, and his last game with us, and he is going to be missed.
Sorely.
I was lucky enough to work with him at NBC, directed by Ken Fouts. Ken, we hope that we will see you again down the road. We know we will, but hopefully we'll see you in the front row.
And you deserve the best, Ken Fouts, the best.
Senior Vice President of Field Operations, Andrea Berry. Vice President of Field Operations, Karen Newman. Hybl on first down in trouble. Whoa. And on his way down and just threw it away, and it was almost picked off. I think they're going to say he's down anyway.
Yeah, I thought he was
and
down.
Now it's going to be grounding. A penalty flag. Robinson and Paul Doran all over Nate Hybl.
I thought his knee was down before he even threw the football. You know, if the knee's down, it's a sack.
Intentional grounding on the offense. It'll be loss of down. At the spot of the foul, second down.
It's just like a sack. Same deal. You lose the down at the spot, just like if you were sacked, you lose the down in the yards. Is his knee down before he delivers the football? Knee down?
Yes.
Who's got the ball? That was a sack. I'll tell you who's going to be upset is Duren. Duren loses a sack. And also, thanks to the Big 12 for the opportunity to do this and all the sports information directors for their help, the coaches, the players. It's been fantastic.
Thanks to Kevin Weiberg, Donnie Duncan. Tim Allen, Bo Carter. It has been a sensational year again for the Big 12 Conference. 2:18 to play with a flag down to the play.
Little face mask right on the sideline as the play was being finished. The block punt that we had, Kansas State-Nebraska game, Tater got a heck of a shot on it right down the field, but it was like he was right there in the backyard. A little high end zone action right there. Jason is the man. Jason's the kid, but Jason's got a world of talent, a world of experience already.
2:18 to play. First and goal. Oklahoma down by 17. Just wants to get it in, try an onside kick.
Oh!
A diving grab,
what a
touchdown.
Play. What a play.
The tight end, Trent Smith, going parallel to the ground. So the ball looked like it might have been a little bit behind him. Great grab.
Trent Smith caught 66 passes last year. This year, coming into today's game, it was about half of that. He was down in the 30s. But today, when he's had to come up big, he's come up very large. Here he is working right here, a little smash route, option route. Gets over the goal line, which is what he had to do. He's working on Massey, the safety. Runs a little smash route right there. Secures the pig.
DiCarlo for the point after. At a 10-point deficit for the Sooners. So they need two more scores. Here comes the onside kick. We return to Stillwater. They're staying warm because they're on top. It's easy when you're winning. The Cowboys have won every step of the way today, in the trenches in particular, and early in the game. Now they can cover the onside kick, it's over. They have beaten the Sooners in just about every phase of the game, and that's a rarity for an Oklahoma team under Bob Stoops. But they've got to cover the onside kick. We've seen stranger things happen. 2:13 to play.
Somebody's going to throw a block here, and somebody's going to try to recover after that block.
It's a good high hop.
Boom.
Out of bounds. So the Cowboys will get it. It was touched. Oklahoma State is going to have it.
Peoples knocked it out.
Two timeouts on the board for the Oklahoma Sooners. They'll use them here with 2:08 to play in the ball. Right at the 50. Seymour Shaw. About three on first down. And did he lose the football? No. They say he's already down. Already on the ground. It'll be second and 7. And the Sooners will use their second timeout if they ever see their coach. Still hasn't stopped it.
He's been screaming for about 10 seconds for that timeout.
He lost about 10 seconds on it.
Yeah.
Right at 10.
Yeah.
So now, need a couple of yards. Don't get it. It'll bring up. And the Sooners will stop at a final time. It'll be 3rd and 2 at the 42. So now the ball game. Two more yards for Oklahoma State. And they can start the party here in Stillwater. Sections that contain the Sooner fans are pretty well cleared out. Those are the only empty seats in this ballpark. The counter, no. Fields on the edge, and he's got the first down. Slides inbounds, first down, game over.
And you know, Joel, just going to note here, Les Miles, the only Oklahoma State head coach to beat both Nebraska and Oklahoma in the same season in school history. It's never happened before in school history at Oklahoma State. So a nice little feather in Les Miles' cap right there.
Start the clock, and now Oklahoma cannot stop it. They couldn't stop Oklahoma State in the first half. Trailed to the break 28-6. They were on the downside all day long. It was a shot. There's no doubt about that.
Oh, Les just got wet.
A very cold shower.
Oh, man. You know, he's got mixed. He's cold, but he's a happy cold.
He looked back at the guys that did it. He goes, you'll get it. You'll pay.
Oh, they got him again. Oh, no. Man.
This whole stadium is living through their players on the sideline. What an experience, and what a renaissance for this whole program to come back like this.
Really. And you know, it wasn't like they didn't have Oklahoma's attention. Oklahoma upset about last year's upset in Norman. I think it's the only home loss they've had with Bob Stoops.
Oklahoma State gave it to them. And are you ready, Dave? It's official.
Yep.
The Cowboys beat the Sooners for the second consecutive season. Look out. Two guys that are going to have some great battles down the road.
Hey, good luck in the championship.
Two quack sacks right there. You heard Les Miles, hey, good luck in the championship. He wants the Big 12 South, which he's a representative of, to beat the Big 12 North. So he said to Bob Stoops, good luck against Colorado in the championship. Here come the goalposts. And you know, oh, I hope nobody gets hurt because it came down quick.
It snapped in a hurry.
Yeah.
So everybody, take care of yourselves down there. We talk about that frequently. So they walk off with one set of goalposts very quickly. I don't think the other is going to be safe before too long, although they've got plenty of security at the other end.
What do you do with those goalposts? Where do you put them?
Let's head downstairs. Join Eric Levitz. Eric.
Coach Miles, I know you want to sing. We're going to be real quick. The first OSU coach to beat Nebraska and Oklahoma in the same season, and this team, what a way to finish 5 out of 6.
It has nothing to do with me, I promise you. It's these guys, these coaches, their willingness to work hard and prepare, and this team's gotten better every game, and we have yet to play our best football.
Okay, so you're headed for a bowl game. You don't know where yet. But game plan, talk about that a little bit. Rashaun Woods was outstanding, but so is the entire offense and defense.
Rashaun Woods is as good a wide receiver as there is in the country, bar none. We call on him all the time. You know, when we need a big play, we go to Woods.
What did Coach Stoops say to you afterward when you agreed?
He was very gracious in defeat. He was he congratulated us just like I would expect him. Very, very good man.
I know this is a Bedlam series. Have you got all the fever of it yet? I mean, these fans are around here ready to attack you after I get through. Has it gotten in your blood yet?
It was a hard-fought victory, and we're going to celebrate well into the night.
Coach, congratulations. Thank you very much. Very victorious coach here. Guys, let's go back up to you in the booth before I'm run over.
Well, Bedlam is the proper term for what is going on downstairs as they celebrate their second consecutive win over the Oklahoma Sooners. Les Miles, that is exchanged each year. The winner receiving that trophy. And it stays in Stillwater. 38-28 the final. Come right back to Lewis Field.